This man, Aubrey Graham, he lives rent free. I mean, rent free in Ye's head, man. Where we at? Yeah. My drop's at.
Hold up, big baby. Hold up, big baby.
Yeah. Hey. She's in love with
who I am.
Back in high school, I used to
bust it to the dance.
Now I hit that FBO with duffels in my hands.
I did half a Xan, 13 hours to LA, had me
out like a light,
like a light.
Slept through the flight.
Oh yeah, wait.
No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man. You niggas ain't no kidding me, a fact. Well, yeah, you heard about
Yeah, we gonna play some of this beef.
Yeah, I know. Hey, yeah. No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man. You niggas ain't no kidding me, a fact. Whoa, I was never snapping when I chat before.
Because I think it's really important to frame this properly.
No friends in the industry.
I mean, because Drake got a mansion on the left side of Ye's brain. Checks over stripes really struck a nerve.
Yeah, I heard some people say they know him as my equal. Truth be told, a son these niggas got, I don't compete with them. Ask about the boy and nigga say he got the streets with them. Niggas so offensive knowing they don't have no defense. Why they all... Yeah.
We'll take it back a little bit more though, man. Me. Hey, anybody tell you about it? Let's go.
I wish everyone could tell me exactly what they need from me. The first second they speak to me, I'm not with all the secrecy, secretly beefing me behind closed doors, but playing it peacefully for the streets to see. My nigga have some decency.
Hold on.
My grandma just died. I'm the man of the house. Penny got back together. You tore the game. Trying
to see titties.
There we go.
Way up, I feel blessed.
Here you go. This is some talk.
Keep niggas traumatized. They try and compromise my condom size. So I Snapchat that whole shit. Try and see titties, try and show dick. And I swear to God, I hope they post it. I'm blessed. Even though
me too.
I get slammed with lawsuits like Cardos, C3POs like Star Wars. They want me by the road holding up cardboard. So I go extra hard on the hard floor. Right now, I'm calling you from my home gym. Right after that, nigga, I'm gone swim. Just did a couple laps in my home pool. And my daughter right there getting homeschooled. I'm blessed. And I was thinking about starting at my own school, a Montessori. In the hallway looking like a Montessori, oh yes. I'm way up, I feel blessed.
It was something I missed. It was something about a pool. Drake's pool, big pool. Rich niggas comparing pools. But Ye talked about Drake. What about Drake? You know what I mean? He talked about Drake and how Drake is devious. How he's, you know. So whatever he calls himself, you know, I think Drake makes great music. I mean, he makes great music. He's not my favorite artist, but I think that, you know, the background music. They obviously have a rivalry, bro. I look at it like the Aaron Rodgers and Russell Wilson rivalry, right? Ye is A-Rod. More talented, more diverse, a little bit older. It's like we shouldn't really be peers. Like, I'm much closer to Brady or Jay than you are. But, like, you putting up these numbers that's putting you up there. But it's with the eye test just don't sit right. You know what I mean? And then, you know. I mean, Aaron is just a creep. He's just such a, you know, he's a wizard. You know, the way he just flicks the ball back foot 50 yards down the field. You know, he runs his own offense and it works. Then you got Russ, you know, go Hawks. Yeah, go Hawks. You know what I mean? Like, he's a fucking cornball, just like Drake, man. I just freestyled that, Najee. You're going to love this one, buddy. But the point of it is, it's like, it's just this rivalry is going to exist and they're not even truly peers. It's like, bro, like your next generation. But you're not peers. But then Ye talked about the psychological warfare that Drake brings to a beef. And I'm just starting to think that Drake is the Grim Reaper. I mean, like Drake is a certified killer. Because let me see, where are my notes at? Because he talked about Drake dropping subs that only they know. He's like, bro, this man will drop a sub and if you know, you know. That's probably why Pusha said what he said, because he been hearing all them subs, because he knew and he knew. He was like, Drake, if you know, you know. And then Ye was like, man, it's like Tyson biting the ear, man. He was like, what people don't realize is Tyson didn't just bite the ear because he's crazy. He poked the Holyfield, poked the bed. You keep poking and poking and poking and boom. Everybody just walking around. I'm just like,
I love you, baby.
Nah, Big Baby ain't crazy. He's crazy. He pushed me to the edge. And I think it's the same thing that happened with Ye. Just imagine he in sicko mode at every party you go to, and you seeing your kids turn up to Drake's verse, and he's threatening your life. And you got to sit there with a smile on your face. Because even when Drake started talking all that gangster shit, like Ye said, bro, we too rich, man. Like we too rich, bro. We too much people. Too many people are making fun money off us. Ain't nothing gonna happen. Nothing's gonna happen. But you want to talk that? You want to talk that nonsense, right? Then talk about, yeah, he moved 5 blocks from him. Here we go. Come on, man. Jesus Christ, yeah. I want y'all to tell me something though. That's what I like. That's what we like. Lost my respect. You not a threat. When I shoot my shot, that shit wetty like on Shaq. See the shots that I took. Listen to like on book. Ooh. Wet like on Lizzie. Huh. I'll be spinning valley circle blocks till I'm busy. Like, where is he? No one seen him. I'm trying to clean him. She's in love with who I am. Like, bro, like, you just listen to that verse. It's like, bro, I'm circling your block till I get dizzy, boy. I'm looking for you. That shit wet like a book. Have you seen book shoot, boy? Except for this year. Water. I don't miss. Like, where is he? Oh, damn, bro. You inside? You hiding from me? Man, you hiding from me? She's in love with who I am. Talking about this man's wife. Doing all this flexing and flogging. Texting all these women in his life. He's like, and when Ye was talking about, text all the women in your life, text your friend girl. Oh, he taking your side hoes too? Ooh, dang. Yeah, you ain't supposed to know I got this thing. Texting them just trying to make me mad, right? And that level of psychological warfare to me, man, that really lets me know that you're dealing with somebody who's just damaged goods, man. Super hurt, man. And who am I to talk about Drake being hurt? Because my mental health is not, you know, I might be passing, but what skill are we on? I'm not on the dean's list here, but it's like, God almighty, you know, like, you're going that crazy on somebody else. What did he do to you? Lost my respect. You know what I mean? Like, Drake don't do no interviews either. He don't do no media. I'm curious to get his side of it. Like, well, why you go crazy on Yeezy like that, man? It's Yeezy, baby. But, you know, you just back a man into a corner and they go crazy. You know, you put a dog into a corner, you're going to get bit. You know, you keep whatever Holyfield was doing, you keep at it, then Tyson bites you ill. Whatever happened between Jokic and Markieff Morris, Markieff finally was just like over and he just snapped and he pushed Jokic and Jokic did that. And all I know is Jimmy Butler was about it. But more importantly, man, this ain't even personal to Drake. This is to the people who listen to this podcast. Bro, don't let, and this is, I mean, because Drake got a mansion in Ye's head, and Drake got a mansion in Ye's head. Now, Ye got a mansion in Drake's head. They both got mansions in each other's heads. Let that hurt go, sis. It ain't worth going sicko mode out here, man. You can't do it.